Hi viewers, welcome to Lambda Solution. Today we are going to see about closed loop control of fuel cell with boost converter. So for that you have to take fuel cell from the MATLAB, okay, and then just you have to fix the rating of fuel cell. So here I'm going to fix the rating of fuel cell, which is equal to 1.26 kilowatts 24 volt fuel cell stack. Okay, so this is proton exchange membrane fuel cell, and click apply, and then here you can see the VA characteristics of the considered fuel cell. So the normal, that means nominal power it can deliver is 1.26 kilowatts, so it can deliver maximum 2 kilowatt. So here we need to design the boost converter, right? So the boost converter going to be designed based upon this, the maximum power rating. But we are going to operate that, we are going to load that fuel cell up to only 1.6 kilowatts, okay? So we can load that fuel cell up to 1.26 kilowatts, and then we need to design the boost converter for 2 kilowatts. So based upon this power rating and this rating, that means voltage rating. So when it operates maximum power rating, so the voltage is around 20 volt, the power is 2 kilowatts. So by using this detail, you have to design the boost converter. So for that, so you have to use this equation, that means program. So the power rating of fuel cell is 2000 watts, and then input voltage, that means when fuel cell operate at the maximum power point, right, maximum operating point, the voltage is 20 volt. And then here I'm going to consider the boost converter frequency is 10 kilohertz, and then output voltage here I'm going to fix is 48 volt at the load side. And this is the formula used for calculating IOT max, ripple inductor current, ripple inductor voltage, and then LNC and then R. Okay, so this R value is for this power rating 2000. But when you have to operate that fuel cell at 1.26 kilowatts only. Okay, so here I am going to simulate this one. So after simulating this, you can see the value for LC and R value. So you can use the LNC for the boost converter. Okay, so here I'm going to develop the boost converter. So by using IGBT diode and then RL, sorry, LC elements. Okay, so for that I'm going to use series RLC branch, and here I'm going to use capacitor. So this capacitor will be known as input capacitor between positive and negative terminal of that fuel cell. Okay, and then we need inductor, right? So for that I'm going to use same element, and then I'm going to change the type to L. Okay, inductor. So and then is going to be connected here. So and then we need IGBT and diode. So here you can use this one IGBT diode. So rotate this one and connect like this. Okay, so and then we need a diode. So use this one and connect this one, and then we need capacitor. So use this capacitor and connect like this. And then we need load, right? So just you got to take that RLC branch, and then here just you got to change to R. Okay, so R here we need to maintain voltage at 48 divided by 1.2643. okay, maximum power rating we are going to load the fuel cell via boost converter. Okay, and then I'm going to connect current measurement in the load side. and then voltage measurement across the load. And then so I'm going to use summer summing block. That means here we are going to use feedback loop. Okay. So minus plus. So and then I'm going to use another block, nothing but constant block for providing the reference. The load voltage will be maintained at 48 volt. Okay. And then I'm going to use PID controller. And then here I'm going to use only PA controller alone, right? And then I'm going to use PWM generator. And then here you have to change to 10 kilohertz. And then its output will be is given to IGBT. Okay. Next you have to change the value for capacitance and the inductor. So just you have to copy that inductance value and paste it here, and then copy this capacitance. So for input and output capacitance, just you have to use both same value, right, for both the input and output capacitor. So R value already we fixed 48, stop 48 divided by 1.26 e power 3. So that means it will automatically calculate, that means formula nothing but V square by P, right? So P equal to V square by R, so R equal to V square by P. So that concept I written this value. Okay. Next you need to measure the detail of fuel cell. That means so we need to measure voltage, current and power of the fuel cell. So here you have to use bus selector and connect this one. So in that just you have to measure, that means select only voltage and current of the fuel cell stack. And then the first will be voltage, second will be current, and third one nothing but the power of the fuel cell. So just you have to multiply voltage and current, so you will get the power of the fuel cell here. So next you have to measure the voltage, current and the power of the load. Okay. So now I didn't do any tuning in the PID controller. So before that you have to use another block, nothing but power GUI. First you have to use power GUI, and then I'm going to simulate the model. So this is fuel cell. And then this is load measurement. Okay. So I didn't do any tuning in the PID controller. Okay. So just I'm going to simulate the model. So we will see the results of the system. Here you can see that so this is the result we are getting from the system. Okay. So that means because of non-tuning of that means we are not tuned the PID controller according with our boost converter design. Okay, so that's why we are getting voltage in the input and output will be zero. Okay, so we need to tune this tune that PID controller. Okay, so for that go to PA controller and then click tune. Okay. And then you can see the PID tuner, and then click identify new plant. Okay. After that click get IO data and click simulate data. So here I'm going to provide the offset will be 0.3. That means the input for the WDLM generator 0.3, and then amplitude I'm going to put 0.3. So initially we will provide 0.3 duty cycle from 0 to 1 second. After 1 second we are providing 0.6 duty cycle to the PWM generator. So it will be generate the pulse according with that 0.3 duty cycle and 0.6 duty cycle. So from that we are getting error, right? So here the error going to be act as a data identification data. So based upon that error signal, we are going to find out the transfer function for the our system. Okay. So here I'm going to simulate this model. So this model will be simulated for 2 times. Okay. So now you can see that for 0.3 duty cycle, we are getting this response after 1 second. The duty cycle going to be changed to 0.3 to 0.6. Okay. So because of that, you can see the changes in the voltage, current and power, load voltage, current and power. Okay. So after completion of the simulation, it again simulate for the 0.3 duty cycle. So after completion of these 2 simulation, right, we will get the identification data, that means error data. Okay. So that error data going to be used for identify the transfer function of the fuel cell with the boost converter model. So now we can see that after completion here we will get that identification data, nothing but error. So next I'm going to apply and close this one. So next I'm going to estimate the, so this is identification data, so we are going to identify the plant. So here we are, I am going to consider one pole plant, right? K divided by T1S plus 1. Okay. So I am going to auto estimate the plant. Green color is our collected data, the blue color is our identified plant. So both are matched each other somewhat. Okay, so I am going to apply. So here you can see that the dotted line, right? Dotted line is actual response. So that solid line known as a tuned response. Okay. So here you can change the 2 parameter. One is response time, another one is transient behavior, right? So I'm going to increase the time. Okay. So I'm going to increase the time to around 0.1. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to use this kind of response. Okay. And then update this block. Okay. I'm going to update the block of the PID controller. Now we can see that. So this is a KPKA value we are getting. So it will be updated here. And then I'm going to simulate the model to check the response of the system, whether we are getting response or not. Now we can see that. So this output voltage, that means we are using closed loop control, that means output voltage control. So here output voltage is fixed at 48 volt, right? So here you can see that the 48 volt will be reached after 0.66 seconds. And also you can see that the current is around, the current almost equal to 26 amps, and power we are getting around 1.25, right? And then here for input, so voltage is around 24 volt, and then current is around 52 amps, and then voltage and power equal to around 1.27, right? So we are getting the results, and then voltage also maintained at 48 volt, right? So you can see the voltage here. Okay, so here you can see that the voltage maintained at 48 volt, right? So here you can see the response, right? Response, that means it settled at around 0.5 seconds, right? So if you want to reduce the settling time, right, you can adjust this one, right? So I'm going to little bit adjust this one. So now you can see that the set here, you can see that around the settling time around 0.01, that means response time, right? So I'm going to use this value. So I'm going to update and then I'm going to check the results. Okay. But we are getting results, but we are having more oscillations, right? So we can use the previous value, right? You can use the previous response, that means previous KPKA. Okay, now you are getting the smooth response, but it will take around 0.5 seconds to settle the reference voltage, right? But we are getting perfect results from this tuning method. So this is a way of tuning a PID controller for any kind of a converter in MATLAB. Okay, so this is a working of closed loop control of fuel cell with boost converter. So from that you can understand the concept of designing the boost converter for fuel cell and tuning of PID controller for boost converter. Okay, thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. Thank you so much. Bye bye.